The Life and Times of Davina McCall, all hosted by Jimmy Carr. Friday Night on 40 is the subject of a comedy roast at 9. Now though, time to deal.
22 boxes. £250,000. Just one question. Welcome to Deal or No Deal. Biggest hello for the Pilgrims. Welcome to the Dream Factory. Good to have you here. Very good to have you here. What a moment we had yesterday. What a moment we had in Amara's game. It was reminiscent of the moment when we had our first ever swap. I remember that. Gosh, that was a good few years ago. When the banker actually said to somebody, you can swap your box. And it was like a ripple went round the whole place. Oh, my word. And it was reminiscent of the first time the banker actually didn't offer any money. You know, he doesn't have to. I remember that moment. And then when he first of all did the banker's gamble, the first time he ever did the banker's gamble, caused a sensation. And we had a moment like that yesterday in Amara's game. It was more than a ripple. It was quite a tidal wave went round here. As everyone went, whoa! Because, bit of negotiation with her and her mum, managed to get the offer up. But there was a condition, of course, from the banker, and that was, OK, you no-deal that offer. You open four boxes in the next round. We had a four-box round yesterday. It was a great moment. Wonder what he's going to do today. Don't think I'd want to play when he's in this mood. Actually, yesterday was a jolly good reminder. It may be your game coming up, but it's always his rules. Chris. Yeah! Chris, come on out here. He's in a feisty mood. I hope you're up for a scrap.
Come on, boys. On my wing. Come on, you will.
We've got Chris Brown here from Bridgnorth in Shropshire. Welcome to your game, Chris.
Thank you, Noel.
Do you want to talk about the angel first, or shall we do photographs first? Or
let's start with a very early photograph, shall we?
A very early photograph.
See where I come from.
Right. That's...
That is my school photograph at the age of 15 with hair. By the age of 20, it had all gone.
Ridiculous, anybody having hair that length. Absolutely ridiculous. Then, that's a beautiful photograph there.
That's my wife, Linda, at our wedding day in 2008. We've got a bit of history, me and Lynn.
Go on, then.
In the fact that I was playing a game of cricket in 1983, and with Lynn's father. And he introduced me to his daughter on her 17th birthday. Unfortunately, I went out on the night time, as I did after a game of cricket, and just forgot all about Linda. So, two marriages later, one for Lynn, one for myself, and seven children later, we finally came back together and have now got, between us, seven teenage children.
Wow, seven teenage children?
Top end have just come out of teenagers.
That is terrifying. That Who would ever want to have that kind of life? But you found the happiness.
We
Excellent.
Did.
Right, who we got here then? Who's this?
It's my brother Kevin.
Hello, Kev.
Hello, Noel.
Charlie good?
He's 4 years younger than me. You wouldn't think it, would you?
feel free to come back at it.
You probably think 10 years younger.
I suppose we ought to just ask you why an angel?
That is the angel of hope. I've always said Linda was my angel. But she said, I think you might need a bit of hope. So I bought the Angel of Hope.
Jolly good. Well, do you want to crack on with the game? I mean, there's loads and loads of things down here.
There is, yes.
Which I'd like to interweave through your game.
That'd be good.
We can get to know you as we find out whether or not you're going to go away with a lot of money.
I know. Hopefully so.
I need you, please, to confirm that you chose box 14 at random before your game began.
That I did.
It is sealed by our independent adjudicator, who seals all 22 boxes and is the only person who knows where the money is. You know the form. You've been here long enough. Mm-hmm. I hope you have an absolutely demon game. Chris, good luck.
Thank you very much.
As I said, there's a lot of children in our lives, so a lot of these numbers represent things. Well, I think every number in the room represents something in my life, but and I'm going to start, if I can find her, with number 12. This is Linda's youngest girl, Kate. So I'll pass you to Brian. Open my box.
Chris, you're a lovely, lovely man. I hope it's blue for you.
Yeah!
That seemed a good start, so we'll stick with Lynn's other daughter, Lauren. It's her birthday on the 8th. So, Steve, if you could open number 8, please.
I'm really happy to blue, mate.
20,000.
He's got a letterbox. Very nice letterbox you got there.
If I'm going to take reds, I need to take the smaller ones. I've got 5 godchildren, so let's hope they can help me out here. Jaron?
Yeah?
Number 5, please.
I hope it's a blue for you, pal. Really do. Right.
Yes!
Come on! Come on, that's a good job. Come on, mate. That's good. Jason, I'm coming to the death box. My eldest lad, it's number 22, so Hetty, if you could open that box for me, please.
Someone tell her.
Right. I'm going to go to my mother now. I need my mother's help. My real mother. Born on the 3rd of October. So, Angela, if you can have number 3, please.
Really hope it's blue. Good luck.
Yeah! Yeah! All right, that's good, 500. Thank you very much. You all right? Happy about that?
Not happy with Jason, but everything else is fine.
Yeah, blame it on the family. Yeah, why not? Hello? Yeah, I'm good, thank you. How are you doing? Yeah, he says he's feeling good. He's up for the challenge. Yeah, he thinks you are formidable. Any man who lives a life with 7 teenage children in his life. Yeah, hats off. Yeah, he's doing the old bowler thing there to you. OK. He thinks you're smart. and he doesn't think you are the kind of player who is going to chase the money blindly. So he actually thinks he's going to have to get your offers absolutely right. I mean, it's quite astonishing, this offer. You've taken 50,000, you took the 20,000, and the box is valued at £10,250. Which is... Which is a lot of respect, frankly.
Yeah. I'm a golfing man, as well as a gambling man. So a lot of my game involves some of my golfing techniques.
Your game is going to involve
golfing techniques. Yeah.
So would you like me to putt the question to you?
Yes, no, I'd like the question, please.
Well, suit yourselves. £10,250. Deal or no deal?
Thank you very much. No deal.
Splendid. Right, come on, Tiger.
Yes. Well, another one of the children. Faddy, number 18, please, mate.
Best of luck, Chris.
Oh, they're starting to cuddle already.
Yes!
Well done. Right.
Yep. Faye, number 10, please.
Hope it's a blow for you. Especially that penny.
Yeah!
Oh, yes.
Go and get it.
Oh, my God.
Hold it.
Just pointing out, you know, because she's given me a lot of grief about the fact she's a vegetarian, doesn't touch meat, no tongues, go on.
Yes, that's good.
All right, with a warm glow still on your lips, would you like to give the nation a very, very good reason why they should return to the second part of your attempt to become wealthy?
Well, yes. If the bank is a golfer, I think I'm...
They're here.
I'm so sorry. I think I'm one up with 16 to play. Come back after the break. Look, let me put some more blues away.
Chris from Bridge North in Shropshire. He's into ground care, well, whatever that is. What's ground care?
Well, I actually look after a lot of sports pitches, but over the years, as I said about golf, I got into playing golf with my ex-father-in-law now over 20 years ago. We used to go around playing and found it very expensive, so we decided to build our own.
Right.
Bill had got a 27 acres of land that he was renting for arable. So we decided to develop into a golf course. So we built ourselves a par 3 golf course on it. It's got 15 holes.
Well, I'm very jealous of you, Chris. I don't understand. You made some golfing reference into the break and everybody cheered and laughed. And I'd attempted one golfing joke and it died and I got booed. I hope things will... Oh, I wonder if this is the bunker. Hello. Go on. You enjoyed the throw to the break. Yes, yes, he hoped you would agree that he was one up with 16 to play. Oh, he can't agree.
There's always 19 holes in my golf course. Yes. The 19th in the bar.
Yes, he said. I hope you're including the bar in your mathematical calculations.
Yes.
Splendid. All right, well, you've got one more to go.
One more to go.
Yep.
Right, I said about the golf course. There's 15 holes on the golf course, so... Gina, number 15, please.
Good luck, Chris. I'm going to miss you.
Oh, so sweet.
Yes! Well, Gina, thank you very much.
Thank you.
You're doing good.
Thank you.
Well, I think that's... I think it's pretty comfortable.
Tidy,
isn't
that?
Yeah, tidy. Oh, I like that. Tidy. That is a very impressive board. Right. He wants me to spell this one out to you. He's now very aware you can't tell the difference between 15 and 16. So this is £16,000.
Green's running for me at the moment. So, £16,000. That's a fantastic offer. But that's a fantastic board. So, at this stage, as a gambling man, I'm ready for the question, Noel.
£16,000, Chris. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Thank you.
The newbie's going to have to come into the game.
Where are we going? Newbie? Hello.
Hello.
Hello, you're very lovely. Where are you from?
I'm from here in Bristol.
Are you? Mm-hmm. Oh, you didn't have to travel far then.
No, not at all. Four miles.
4 miles? And what do you do?
I'm a crime scene investigator.
Are you?
I am. CSI. CSI Bristol.
Oh. She says that with real pride, doesn't she? Karen, you're very welcome.
Thank you.
And please open six and give him something that he wants.
Chris, I really hope my first ever box is a blue for you.
Thank you, Karen.
Do you know, there's something ironically appropriate about a crime scene investigator murdering his game. That wasn't very nice of her, was it?
It wasn't, no.
Shocking. Oh, come on, Chris, there's still some big money there, mate. Yes.
Not very nice of her.
OK, positive.
Yep.
Stay back up. Yep, that's good.
Yeah, you were
seen
better.
It enough times.
You were better off over there.
Yeah. So, Christine, number 9, please.
Okay.
Thank you, Chris.
From one Chris to another, I hope this is a blue.
15,000. Ooh, the game is swung, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Ooh, it's like one of your golf clubs. That's really a big swing in that game.
OK. Number 21, please, Marley. Good mate.
Thank you, Marley.
Good luck, mate. Obviously, came on the same day together. You've been an absolute pleasure to meet and stuff. Good luck to you.
Yes! Well, that's a little bit better, but that was a horrible round.
Very good, mate.
I don't think the banker's going to like that. Ooh, I think he got back in the game.
He did. He did.
He got back there big time, didn't he?
Put my guard down.
Hello. Yeah, he was having a strong game. Yeah. OK, he's claiming that you took it out relatively early and that can be very difficult to come back from. So he's now feeling a lot better about you. You started at 10,250, which was fantastic. Climbed to 16,000. Oh, my word, he's whipped your legs away. Yeah, 6,000. I think he got his driver out and just had a.
Yes. He's taken a big divot there, hasn't he? Still some good money on there, isn't there, lads?
Definitely.
Come on, Chris.
Big money on there. I think we're going again. Yeah, I think so. Okay, Noel, I'm ready for the question.
£6,000. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Thank you.
Thank you.
He's right, there is big money there, but he's going to have to be careful.
The next phase of my game is number 16 with Lily, please.
We're into a phase, Lily.
3,000.
Yeah.
That's what I want. That's what I want. Yes. It's going to be 17, Pat. Another birthday of the children, please.
Yeah! Come on! Come on! Yeah! What is it about you and opening those boxes? You can't quite do it, can you?
She did it for me.
Stiff for me.
Sorry?
Stiff for me.
OK, we're coming up to 8 box. You said a really important thing when you were considering that last offer. You said there's still a lot of money there. There is. This is a fascinating game. You're still looking very strong. Feeling good about it?
Feeling good.
All right, make sure you're here to see Chris change his life forever. See you shortly. Ground care worker and whatever, and he's got his own golf course, but he's short of 3 holes for some reason. I don't know. And 50p or a pound now, that would be strategically
very
a very good
nice.
Move.
That would be very nice. Getting down to some serious boxes as well now.
Yes, you are.
Going to be lovely, Jess. 19, please.
Good luck, Chris. I hope it's a blue.
And I. That's a good. That's a good.
We're happy with that.
Fine,
it would have been great to have a 6-2, but that's good.
It's as good as a blue.
Good as a blue.
It was a moment of hesitation, but I think we're pretty happy about that.
Yes, yes, yes.
Hello, welcome back to Chris's game. Couple of small reds, but he's conceding it's gone back in your favour. OK, he thinks your offers are going to sort of hang in that hole there between 10 and 35, and he thinks it's going to make it very tricky, therefore, to play this game and know when's a good moment to go. So he actually thinks you should leave now. 11 and a half. Ooh, I like that. Immediate cry of good offer. 11 and a half thousand. That's a good offer.
I think anybody that wants to play this game, and I just love the chance to play this game, would love to be able to get to the last two boxes. Obviously, it doesn't always work out like that. We've seen games where you just haven't got the opportunity. Sometimes you're actually forced to go that far. I've got the dilemma now of being in a really healthy situation there.
Hello. Oh, he says, I don't often admit I've made a mistake, but he's admitting he's made a mistake, yeah? Oh, he thinks he phoned too quickly and he hadn't thought it through. $14,000.
Yep.
Not 11 and a half, 14.
It's getting better.
Have a think about this. Why would he do that? Why would he do that?
I don't know. My problem is I'm a committed gambler. I ought to be committed sometimes. But I just love having a gamble and having a go. I said to Kevin on the way down, I said, you might have to pull my reins in at some point. Is it yet or not?
Not yet.
Not yet.
Not yet. Oh!
Yeah.
You might just start reaching for him, though. Hello. Interesting. Very interesting. He's wondering who is actually driving this game. So you're ready to put your hands on the reins and give a sharp tug.
Yeah.
And get brother to pack it in. It's now 17,000.
£17,000.
Kev?
They're starting to be pulled in. You've got to think about it now.
Yes, yeah, yeah, yeah. £17,000.
A lot of money.
A lot of money. And it's my game.
Oh, hang on, that's the gambler coming out there. You ready for the question?
I'm ready for the question, Noel.
Here we go. £17,000. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Well, a lot of people say we're now in the business part of the game. I wish you good luck.
Month I was married to Lynn, July, number 7, please. Please,
all
right,
Annie. What are we talking? 10 grand down.
10 grand down.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Blue would be brilliant. Go, Annie, go.
Good luck.
Yeah.
10 grand down. 10 grand down. That's one. That's one. Right. Pressure time. Feeling good, Darren?
I really, honestly, I don't get any feelings from boxes at all, mate.
I just hope and pray that it's a blue for you, but...
OK, I've got one grandchild, Charlie. Number one.
Come on,
man. Let's go, Darren.
I know how much Darren would like to make sure that he in no way assists the banker in this round. Go for it, Darren.
Chris, come on, you're an absolute gentleman. I'm going to miss you and Kev. Best of luck.
Yeah!
Okay. Okie dokie. Right.
Oh dear.
Wouldn't this be sweet if you can pick up $5,000 or a blue?
Wouldn't it just? Well, if it's going to be my day, I'll stick with myself. My birthday, number 11, please, Paul.
Paul? Pull the seal, please, on box 11.
Yes! Come on!
Yes.
Wow.
That is, whatever he says, believe me, my experience says that configuration always screams out, you are very, very likely to go away a wealthy man. Yes, of course, you could still only get £100. But it is such a powerful combination. You've got to be pleased about that.
Oh, tremendously pleased.
And you've got to be very unpleased. Yeah? No, you did say that at the very beginning. He said, right at the beginning of your game, he knew he was going to have to get the offers absolutely right. And quite clearly, he hasn't done that because you're still sitting
right
there.
That's right. I'm still here.
To talk to you.
Hello, Mr. Banker. Thank you. An awful lot of money, Mr. Banker. An awful lot of money. I have a target. I think it might jeopardize my position. Yes. Well, the problem I have, Mr. Banker, is what's down in that bottom right-hand corner. That is, we both have the same dilemma. Sounds very good. Sounds very good. How far can your arm be twisted, Mr. Banker? Oh. Thank you.
Could you give us the heart of the conversation?
It was a bit of bartering going on, but there was something there that he's getting close to now, on a figure. And I've forgotten what it was. £28,750. I've forgotten what it was.
Wow, you made quite an impression on him. Right, thank you for clarifying that. OK. Was the final figure 750?
No.
Was it 28,750?
Yes, that was the one.
Right, your box is now valued at £28,750. I think it's time to say to Kev, do you want to reach for the tack and grab the reins?
It's already on.
Reins on?
It's all on.
Wow.
How does the gambler feel, though?
Oh, the gambler wants to go on. The gambler wants to go on. Steve, you're a gambler.
There's a 4-to-1 chance there. There's a red in your box, and it could be one of them big ones.
With that board, I'd tell everybody to play on.
Can I open that box?
No, I open it.
Chris. Yeah. Chris. Can I allow Noel to open that box?
You've also said to a few people as well, you're now going to make that lonely, lonely decision that only the people that can go for the big money have to make to be able to hand back that huge amount of money and take the courage and take the plunge to go for the big life-changing sums of money.
Kev, you've said you've tugged the reins. Why should he stop?
People say they go there like once-in-a-lifetime chance just to win the life-changing money. He's now got his life-changing money.
Oh, how would I feel if it's £100,000? How would I feel? Oh, he's played with me, Molly. I'm ready for the question, Noel.
28,750 pounds. Deal or no deal?
Deal.
That was very difficult. Such a good board, and I think play a good board.
Come on, Mummy.
That was fantastic. I've played a good game.
I hope I've played a good game now.
Do you know, there is something very disturbing about this segment of your game. Every time that banker gets talking to the player, he gets his wish. Or has he, in this case? Is there one that you would definitely have kept?
Number four.
Number four.
The day I got married.
So we're talking about 2, 13 and 20. Which one do you wish to go for?
Two.
Christopher?
Lucky number.
We two. All now know the framework of this game. We know exactly what we want to see. What you got?
Good luck, Chris.
75,000. Confirm your next choice.
It's that was my lucky number. Lynn's lucky number is 13.
Kieran, where you go? What you got? This has got to be 100 grand.
That's right, Debs.
It's really got to be. Go on, Debs, open 20.
I've only had ever one big one and it were 100 grand, so I hope it's again.
Oh, wow! 5,000 or 100,000? Have you got 5,000 in this box or 100,000? Hello. He just said, you will forgive me, but I'm feeling rather proud of myself. Committee gambler, yeah. Yeah, brave man. Here to change his life, yep. Yeah, with an incredibly strong board. If you could have resisted his charms, his powers of persuasion, you would have now been considering £44,000. Wow. It would have been 44. Wow. Now we're going to find out whether you could have had the last laugh. Were you destined to be one of the biggest winners in the history of Deal? Yes.
Alex.
Yes is the answer. Who's Alex?
The one that always takes the money away from me.
Who's Alex?
Linda's son.
Your reaction said it all.
Yes, it did.
The way you came out of that chair said it all.
I came for that.
You could have had it.
I came for that.
Alex, finish the game, please.
Well done, Chris.
£5,000 sitting there. How are you feeling?
Mixed emotions. Had a great game, just couldn't quite get to the finish line.
You got one great consolation.
I certainly did.
£28,750.
Thank you, man.
Of consolation.
Thank you very much. Enjoy your money.
There is one frightening fact for these guys. They do not have the option of refusing to talk to the banker. It's a shame that they can't exercise that option, because when they do, in that situation, he almost always gets them out of the game. Fascinating stuff. See you tomorrow.
It's midweek in the Warwickshire Kitchens, next on 4 for Come Dine With Me.